Hello guys, and welcome to this short video about implant planning, okay? So how to perform virtual implant planning on the CBCT images of your patients. On the screen you guys are seeing an implant planning software, okay? So this is a very common interface for this type of software. That's the dental slice software from Bioparts. And then we have the key points here. So the first key point is the 3D measurements of the alveolar bone. So we can perform linear measurements of the bone dimensions for us to plan our dental implant. And the two most important measurements, the bone height available and the bone width available, so the buccal lingual width at the level of the alveolar crest. Of course, we can do those linear measurements with precision because CBCT has no significant distortion, okay? So they would be true 1-per-1 measurements of the alveolar bone. It's very important to remember that for the bone width, we should leave at least 1 millimeter buccal and 1 millimeter lingual of remaining bone after we plan our implant. And the bone height available we can measure from the alveolar crest to the next important anatomical structure that we need to avoid. So basically, the implant planning on the posterior maxilla can be measured from the alveolar crest to the sinus floor. Then in the anterior maxilla, of course, we can plan from the alveolar crest to the nasal floor. And then on the posterior mandible, a case like this, for example, then we need to be very careful because we have two structures that we need to avoid. One of them is the mandibular canal and the other is the submandibular fossa. So we have the submandibular gland, we have even blood vessels in this area, and we want to avoid hitting this area with our drills. And we should always be careful regarding the anterior mandible as well, because in regard to the buccal lingual width, the ridge can be very narrow sometimes and you don't want to damage the buccal plate or the lingual plate, for example. But of course, nowadays, the implant planning softwares, they don't allow us only to do measurements. They also allow us to virtually place the implant, as you guys are seeing on the screen. So we should place those implants following up on the different slices, on the different planes at the same time, until we find the ideal position of our implants. So this leads us to the second key point, which is that the position of the implant should also be prosthetically driven. So not only according to the availability of bone, but also according to the future prosthesis, because the implant will be restored with a prosthesis. And of course, there are several guidelines regarding where the final position of your implant should be. I will just give you guys some examples because this is a short video. Regarding the horizontal distance, your implant should be 1.5 millimeters at least away from the adjacent tooth, right? And this would allow us to have a very nice papilla afterwards. Vertically, the final position of the implant platform should be around 2 millimeters distant from the level of the CEJ of the adjacent teeth. And then there are several other guidelines, publications about different techniques, but let's see the case that we have here. So for this case, you guys are seeing that this implant planning was further developed and two implants were actually planned to rehabilitate the two lower left molars. And you guys are seeing on the top left clinical image, the two implants placed on the alveolar crest with a conventional flap without releasing incisions, for example. And after an os integration period of 6 weeks, as recommended for this type of implant, so those are tissue level Straumann implants, we performed the impression of the implants using transfer abutments. So you guys are seeing the try-in of the splinted copings, and then on the images below, you guys are seeing the final clinical results of the porcelain fused to metal implant supported crowns that were installed, and those are of course screw retained implant supported crowns. Also remember that since this should be prosthetically driven, we should start from a conventional or digital wax up. And of course, this is even easier if we can have an idea of the prosthesis, or even, for example, if we can see the virtual wax up superimposed to the CBCT images. And that's why it's very important to define the ideal position of our dental implant using all the planes that are available on the CBCT image, okay? So you guys are seeing all these planes, and on the top left, you guys have 9 cross-sectional CBCT images. This is the name of those images. On the top right, you guys have the axial plane. On the bottom right, you have the three-dimensional reconstruction, which is also useful. You guys can even see the conditions of the third molar that is distal to the implant, with furcation exposure, and of course this would be extracted. And on the bottom left, you guys have an image that is similar to an OPG, and this image is called coronal panoramic view. And of course it's also useful to plan our implants and to see the mesial distal distances that we have between adjacent implants or between implants and the adjacent teeth. So those were the tips of today, and see you guys in the next videos.